Thank you for inviting me, and maybe I will say something about initial point of investigation is so-called Jacobian conjecture. It's famous from the false proofs. Each 3 months, one new proof. There are some so-called people who are engaged in Fermat's theorem. They are called Fermatists, and people who are involved same way in Jacobian conjecture is Jacobins. let's formulate Jacobian conjecture, and which provide initial point for investigation. Jacobian conjecture, GC, index n, says following. Suppose we have a polynomial mapping. Xi goes to Pi of x. X means x sub 1, x sub n. Mapping P. The question is when P is invertible. Of course, in order to be invertible, it should be local invertible. If it's not local invertible, it cannot be also global invertible. In order to be local invertible in some point, its Jacobian matrix dpi dxj should be degenerated in each point. It means that determinant of it should be never zero. Otherwise, it's not invertible in neighborhood of some point, and then we stop talking about invertibility of it. But if it is non-zero for every point, and this is polynomial, it provides that it is non-zero constant. So in order to be invertible, it should be non-zero constant. Of course, with composing with similarity, we get to the situation when determinant is one, because we can compose it with linear transformation and get one. So the question is following. Suppose this determinant of Jacobi matrix is one. Is it true that this mapping is invertible? One comment: if it is invertible as a function, as a mapping, in set theoretical sense, then its inverse would be polynomial mapping as well. It's not big deal to prove it, and it is in some standard book like Van den Essen book, Polynomial Automorphisms and Jacobian Conjecture. I don't have time to argue why it is so. If inverse is in set theoretical sense, it has inverse, then inverse is polynomial mapping also automatically. So no reason to discuss what does it mean inverse. If it is invertible in set theoretic sense, then inverse is automatically polynomial mapping. What can be said about this? Easy remark that Jacobian conjecture 1 is trivial, because if you have just one mapping, it's Jacobian matrix is just derivation of it. Determinant is just derivation, and the function with a constant derivation is a linear function. It's certainly invertible. So this is not a result. GC1, it's a trivial observation that it is true. What can be said about GC2? It's famous for false proofs, and community considered it to be proved from 1948 till 1968. It was proven, and in 1968 it was disproven. by Makar Limanov. So community trusted that Jacobi and even one master student suffered from it, because student, I forgot his name, was asked to prove Jacobian conjecture for n equal to on the exam for master degree, and did not succeed in order to do it. As a result, he got not excellent mark. Nowadays, from up till now, it is open even for n equal to. This conjecture is famous from the false proofs. Almost every 3 months, it's new false proof of this subject. So, classical algebraic geometry, in order to, up to my opinion, it does not matter much. This is one issue.
Consider complex space.
Of course, let's make a comment. If you consider real space, If determinant matrix is non-zero, it's positive, it can be not to be constant. And then counterexample. So sometimes it's up to my opinion, it's not good wrong understanding. If you have just local invertibility in a real case, it can be not to be global invertible, but when because on the real case, determinant can be not to be constant, just can be polynomial with positive values. Ну, for example. And then the mapping can be not to be invertible. So for complex case, so it makes sense for complex case. So I think I answered your question. So we don't talk anymore on the real situation. And this is open for up till now from GC, from GC2. And of course, in order to attack Fermat theorem, you have to know what does it mean number, what is a multiplication, what is a power addition. In order to attack Jacobian conjecture, you need to understand what does it mean determinant and partial derivative. Means, hence the people who Jacobins is less community than Fermatist people. However, number of suicide is more than in Fermatist people. For people who unsuccessful attacked Jacobian conjecture. And this is very slippery problem. I will use Russian word «склизкая». Скользкое, склизкое, it is. What can be said about, there is another conjecture, which is called Dix-Mier conjecture. It says following. Consider VL algebra, AN. What is it? This algebra generated by multiplication on Xi and derivation by Di. It's algebra of differential operators. One can consider, from formal algebraic point of view, it can be considered that algebra with this generate certain relations xi, xj, di, dj is zero. Uv, it's uv minus vu. This means uv minus vu. And xi dj equal delta ij. It's Kronecker delta. It is one if I equal j, otherwise zero. Let's comment this. If you have function f, and if you first derive, then multiply by x, you have this. If you first multiply by x and then derive, you get f plus xf prime. If you subtract this from that, you will get F. So it's an identical map. Maybe I missed sign minus, but in fact it is a algebra, Weyl algebra from these formal generators and from these formal relations, which provides you possibility to consider it over a field of arbitrary characteristic. So this is Weyl algebra. And now I am ready to formulate the Xmier conjecture for n. DCn, it means following, it acts. Where the nth of an over C equal out an over C. This is the Xmier conjecture. Question mark means is it true? So what can be said about the Xmier conjecture?
Can you repeat
the
statement? Endomorphisms of this algebra?
Does it mean that every non-zero endomorphism of this algebra is invertible? Endomorphism equal automorphism. Of course, no, I mean non-zero. One comment. First of all, any endomorphism of this algebra, if non-zero, is monomorphism. It cannot have any kernel. No, that's easy, but in order for convenience of auditoria, let me prove it just for convenience. Suppose we have endomorphism, and suppose P belongs to the kernel of this endomorphism. It says something to zero. Then xi is this, and this would be also sent to zero. No, commutator of every element who will be sent to zero will be also sent to zero. So if p is differential operators, if it contains some derivation, one can commute it with x and drop down the degree. No, just if it has derivation respect to xi, let's commute it with multiplication of xi, you will get differential operators of smaller order. If p is not differential, if p is differential operators of order zero, then one commute it with derivation. And drop down of its polynomial and drop down degree. And finally, you get to constant. If endomorphism has non-zero constant in kernel, that everything is in kernel. If everything is in kernel, it's zero endomorphism. So it's every non-trivial endomorphism, it is zero. So it is simple algebra. Nothing can be easier than simple numbers and simple algebras. However, the question, the real question is, does it epimorphism? Is it true that every endomorphism of Weyl algebra is epimorphism? In fact, this is non-trivial question. Open up till now. What is was known in 1968, the Xmier proved that DCn implies GCn. Why it is so? I don't want to provide complete proof in order to save our time, but I want to say that if you consider Mij, minors of Jacobian matrix, of this matrix. If you put dj, sum by j, and denote it by delta I, one can prove that delta I pi commutators is pj, is delta ij. This is standard notation, and this is Kronecker delta, also standard notation. Sorry for using letter delta for incompatible senses. And so if you have and also dij commutes, so if you have morphism with unit Jacobian, then one can send di to delta I, xi to pi, and you will have the same commutator relations, and one can get endomorphism of VL algebra. If Jacobian conjecture is true, it is invertible. Of course, from that it's not big deal to get invertibility of polynomial part of this, because one can suspect that inverse may send function to differential operators, but it's not so because of commutativity or something like that reasoning. So it is not big deal, so it is well known from this year that this implication. This implication still true if n is one. It's true, but here this is trivial statement if n is one, and this is unknown. But implication still true. So it was known. What was the starting point of Kontsevich conjecture? It was several people. It was independently by Tsushimoto.
Does one know what to expect out of endomorphisms or AM?
Sorry?
Does one know what to expect the endomorphism or the automorphism be?
Let's say this is the same is what do we expect for Jacobian conjecture. I want to say, let's say, for maybe if Jacobian conjecture is true, then this is also true. Then
the question was about, do we know any candidate for this group of automorphism?
I will talk about this later. It is, Kontsevich conjecture says that automorphism group is isomorphical to polynomial simplectomorphism group. And this is a result which I am claiming. At least I have archived paper and send it to Kontsevich. He says that he promised me to read it carefully. And this is an archive. So let's say that automorphism and polynomial simplectomorphism groups, they are isomorphical. This is claim of my talk. Now I need to give motivation and to explain some preliminaries, but I have archive paper on that. No, I think I gave preliminary answer on your question. And the mechanics of proofs, of course, and why this subject is interesting. It's Tsushimoto and Kontsevich and me proved another application that GC to N implies DCN. For example, if Jacobian conjecture for N equal 2 is true, then Dixmier conjecture for 1, it is also true. That the situation. And now, in order to discuss Kontsevich conjecture, I want to say following. I need to discuss how this implication was proven. And if I discuss how this implication was proven, this gives enough background explanation why this conjecture is really interesting. And the mechanics of proof of this. Now, so what shall we do in order to prove it? Let's consider reduction of VL algebra modulo prime numbers. It's convenient to take prime numbers to be infinitely large in the sense of non-standard analysis, but let's first consider reduction modulo P. If you consider what is the reason to make reduction modulo p, algebra of differential operators is strictly infinitely dimensional algebra. Ну, it is. However, if one reduct it modulo p, it has a huge center. Namely, x to the p commutator d equal p x to the p minus 1. And if p is characteristic of ground field, it is zero. It's zero. So, and same can be, we can write similarly d to the p x, it would be minus p d to the p minus 1. It is still zero. Hence, it becomes finitely dimensional algebra over its center. And by the way, using characteristic p reduction, one can define what does it mean determinant of differential operators meaning of all of this. So it all of, so so the struggle and all no consideration with positive characteristic and work with algebra stuff, the reason of it we buy is coming to finitely dimensional algebras from infinitely dimensional algebra of differential operators. This is the reason for considering model P reduction. That's why we can, of course, model P reduction, not everything is so smooth, but at least it provides some finitely dimensional properties. And that's the reason to make this work out. Okay, now I want to say following thing. So it becomes finitely dimensional over, suppose we have endomorphism of algebra of differential operators. Xi goes to pi of x and d means x is so x means z and d means d1 d sub n. What shall we get? And so, suppose di is qi of x d. Suppose we have endomorphism of VL algebra. Then one can consider it reduction modulo p. Of course, not always we can get success in order to reduct it modulo p. For example, we try to reduct it modulo 2, and 2 is in the denominator of some coefficient. This can happen. Or reduct it modulo 3, and 3 participate in denominator of coefficients. But if p is sufficiently large, prime, we don't have this property. We have only finitely many bad primes who participate in denominators of the coefficients. Because if we fix endomorphism, it has finitely many coefficients. One can choose algebraically independent set of them. All other will be expressed from them via algebraic functions. And only finitely many bad primes will participate in denominators. But if we choose infinitely large primes in the sense of non-standard analysis, we don't have these properties at all. Let me, in my talk, just ignore these problems. I just pointed out way how to do it, but it is in archive paper, it is well published and so on. So there is some standard way to make it politically correct and to ignore all of these issues respect to denominators. So we can consider it reduction modulo p if p is big enough and not bad, not participate in the denominators of coefficients. So that's, I just I cannot write down all of this algebraic standard technique how to treat, but let me say this. Next idea is following. It sends center to center. What does it mean? Of course, image of center commutes with image. That's obvious, because if it is center, if U is in the center, then UV is zero for any V, hence F of U reduction U F of V would be F of zero if it would be zero. It's certainly for any V. So image of center obviously commutes with image. But possibly image is not everything. It commutes with image of center, but maybe it does not commute with something else. But this is not true, it commutes with everything, and proof is based on following argumentation. Weyl algebra, modulo P, is Azumaya algebra. Each its finitely dimensional factor behaves as, simple factor is algebra of n time of matrix, P power n times P power n matrix over field. And if you have image and something outside which does not commute with center of your image, it means that image does not hold all polynomial identities of this matrix. But it's not true because whole algebra satisfies this identity. So there are some standard way. It's not so difficult. It is not a stupid way to prove it, but it is well known and well published. This part of proof. So in fact, image of center belongs to the center. And the next thing is that the center of algebra, Weyl algebra reduction modulo P is isomorphic K of X to the P, D to the P, P's powers of XI, DI. This certainly belongs to center. Every polynomial on this also belongs to center. But if differential operators on some variable has order not divisible by P, then one can commute and not to get zero. So image of it means that xi to the p, that's because it is endomorphism. That's nothing. And because center goes to center, it provides some polynomial. I will denote them as pi. Let's denote it as this on the x1 to the p, x sub n to the p, d1 to the p, d sub n to the p. And this is a qi of x1 to the p, x sub n to the p, d1 to the p, d sub n to the p. So it means that because it belongs to center, then it is polynomial respect to these guys. What is the degree of this polynomial? Exactly as the degree of this differential operator. Why? First of all, we put p's power here, we increase it p times. From other hand, when we change variable, we decrease it p times. Hence, we will get exactly the same degree. What happens with the highest coefficient, with highest term? Coefficient with highest term would be p's power of this coefficient. Because all non-commutativity effects have effects on the smaller terms, because commutator has smaller order, and the commutativity, non-commutativity, so highest term of product is product of highest terms of differential operators. That's why highest term of this is p power highest term of this. Same for this. What can we do? Let's took roots of order p, coefficient twice. Because Frobenius is automorphism of the commutative ring, inverse we can also define, and if we do inverse coefficient twice, all commutator relations will be held, and then we will get, instead of polynomial endomorphism, xi goes to pi of xd, di goes to qi of xd, we will get another mapping, xi tilde goes to pi of xi, x tilde, dy tilde, and yi goes to qi of x tilde y tilde, x tilde xi tilde equal xi to the p, yi tilde equal yi to the p, and coefficients of this is the same as coefficient of this. That's reason why we took inverse Frobenius coefficient twice, and highest coefficient here is a equal highest coefficient here. So instead of automorphism, endomorphism of VL algebra, we have some polynomial morphism. So far we don't know property of this polynomial morphism. But I want to say, and there is another idea showing that in fact this is a symplectomorphism, and this endomorphism provides symplectic structure. Let's, I want to say that on reduction model, on the VL algebra model P over the center, there are Poisson bracket. Let's define them. What is the Poisson, how to define? Suppose we have two differential operators. No, say P and Q, who belongs to the center of VL algebra, k of x to the p, d to the p. One can lift them to characteristic zero, get p and q in arbitrary way, then commute. Result would be divisible by p. Let's divide it by prime number p and send back to characteristic p. And this is well-defined operation. Because logically, result may be dependent on way how we lift p to p hat and q to q hat. However, it's independent. Let's say why. If we lift to characteristic zero some differential object, we have some ambiguity. What shall we can? We can add some p times r. A is arbitrary. That's our ambiguity. So we have extra term, but p times a will be cancelled from this p. So we will get a q. Additional term. And if we send it to characteristic zero, it would be cancelled because q is in the center. It means that this is well-defined operation, and direct computations shows that x to xi to the p, di to the p commutator divided by p is p minus 1 factorial modulo p, which is minus 1. This is direct computation shows. It means that this, so on the center of Weyl algebra, one can define the structure of Lie algebra brackets. And these brackets are Poisson brackets. And our mapping preserves this Poisson bracket. It is, and if some mapping preserves Poisson bracket, then it preserves symplectic structure and it preserves standard form dxi dyi. This is a standard symplectic form. What is a symplectic form? It is in the book of textbook in differential geometry. There is some notion, but just I want you to trust that if mapping is preserves this bracket, it means that image of coordinate, it means that qi pi qi equal qj equal delta ij all other delta a zero. Then this mapping, then this equal some dpi dqi. One can check it, but trust me, then it is true. It's really true. Our paper is in archive, all computations are in the internet. So, and if mapping preserves symplectic forms, it preserves its nth power. If mapping preserves nth power of symplectic forms, it preserves volume. If mapping preserves volume, then its Jacobi, determinant of Jacobian matrix is one. If Jacobian conjecture for two n variables is true, then this restriction on the center is invertible. No, if we trust in Jacobian conjecture for n equal to, then it's invertible. If it is invertible or restriction on the center, from that one can get that it is whole map is invertible as well. It's, of course, it's not pretty, it's not trivial statement, but it's not difficult to prove. And that's why Jacobian conjecture for two n variables implies Dixmier conjecture for n variables. It is, but so I just said about my paper with Maxim, and this paper provides some other problems, further problems which I want to discuss, say why it is natural and important, and maybe point out way of proving it. This is one comment is following. We have this construction. Lift to characteristic P, then zero commute divide by P and send back to characteristic P. But let me remind Kantsevich quantization theorem. There is a Bertrand Keller book, a notes on Kantsevich quantization theorem. It is a good way to prove it. And what it says. Suppose we have a Poisson structure. What it means? Suppose you have associative commutative algebra A. It means that it is associative and commutative respect to addition and multiplication. Also, it has Poisson bracket. What does it mean? It means that it has Lie algebra structure respect to these brackets. And brackets are related with multiplication by following way. AB bracket C equal A bracket C times B plus B bracket C times A. So it is Leibniz rule. Relations between Poisson brackets and multiplication. Standard brackets is following F, G. If you have variables x1, xn, y1, yn is following. Is sum over I from 1 to n, df by dxi, dj, dyi minus df, dyi, dj, dxi. It is a standard bracket. For example, Poisson bracket, which one can see in analytic mechanics. It's, so, suppose we have algebra, formal algebra, with Poisson bracket, Lie algebra respect to this, commutative algebra respect to this, and this is a connection between multiplication and brackets. Then, on the algebra A of H, one can get so-called star multiplication operator. What this means? A star B is AB modulo H A of H. Formal power series. It means that it is a Planck constant. So it is deformation on multiplication. Another condition is following. A star B minus B star A. Let's divide it by H is AB by the same module. So such operation exists. Now I want to compare this with that. Prime numbers play number play the same role as a Planck constant. So we see that it is pretty similar stuff. So instead of Poisson brackets, one can use Planck constant. It is if H tends to zero from non-commutative, one gets brackets. And here, if you consider modulo P, trace of non-commutativity is this Poisson bracket. So it's a similar effect algebraic, but just here we have small, it's modulo P, here we have small in the sense of Planck constant. So this is somehow quantization thing. And if we quantize standard Poisson bracket, we will get algebra of differential operators. And Kantsevich conjecture saying that group of automorphism of VL algebra is isomorphical to group of polynomial symplectomorphism says that after quantization, group of automorphism, or if we trust in Jacobian conjecture, we can say about endomorphisms as well. We can formulate it for automorphism and for endomorphism is the same. It means that in this situation, quantization is equivariant. So this is motivation of this conjecture. Сколько у меня времени? Примерно, ну, осталось. Сколько? Нет, ну сколько?
Прошло 45 минут.
Прошло 45 минут, а традиции у вас какие?
Час с мелочью.
Ну просто я... Простите, но я должен задать тот вопрос, который я вам задал.
Нет, конечно.
Собственно... And... So and the Kantsevich conjecture, now I'm ready to formulate Kantsevich conjecture. I had to give this motivation. Why this conjecture is interesting? So it says, so it is Kantsevich conjecture. It says that, is it true that out of the of IN is it true sim polyectomorphism of C to N? If because Jacobian conjecture is not known so far, we can formulate another version of this and asking and AN also sim N of C to N. If Jacobian conjecture is true, we can no need to distinguish between simplicto automorphism and simplicto endomorphisms. But if we don't have Kantsevich Jacobian conjecture, we have to distinguish, and then we need to formulate it is in these two ways. This conjecture. Now I claim it that this conjecture is solution of this conjecture, but before I do this, let me give some comment of this conjecture. First of all, it looks because if you have endomorphism of line, you have just linear maps and nothing interesting for endomorphism of line. What we have on the endomorphism of VL algebra? Maybe there are some examples, not only linear. For example, this way. Xi goes to Xi plus some polynomial A, let's it depend F of Di. And Di to itself. It's certainly endomorphism because commutator of this is zero, and this preserves commutator relations. No, it looks innocent. No, I just provide one example of endomorphism, and this example looks a bit stupid. Okay, but one can do another stuff. Xi goes to Xi, Di goes to Di plus some polynomial G of X. This also would be endomorphism. Also, we can have some linear endomorphism, something like this. X1 goes to X1 plus X2. Di1 goes to Di1 minus D2. Maybe I need to divide by square root of 2, but maybe not. Now I want to say x2 goes to x1 minus x2. Sorry. Now it's correct. D2 goes to d1 minus d2 divided by square root of 2. This also linear endomorphism. Of course, one can write a lot of them. No, this is innocent, but one can consider compositions, for example, of this guy with that guy and with that guy. All endomorphism who can be presented as compositions of linear one and this elementary one are called tame. All stuff which is not composition is called wild. Nobody knows does wild endomorphism of VL algebra exist. For three-dimensional space, it was conjecture of Nagata, and Shostakov and Umerbaev proved that Nagata automorphism is wild. And and nobody knows any wild automorphism in any dimension but three. It was a big paper, in Journal of American Mathematical Science of papers of Shostakov and Umerbaev, very technical, and if somebody wants to read it, I advise paper of re-exposition of Kuroda. It's much better. No, not read first directly Shostakov and Umerbaev, but first read Kuroda, and after Kuroda, it became possible to read Shostakov and Umerbaev. It, no, person who invents something usually write not the best paper for reader. It happens. And the question is, if you consider this correspondence between VLI algebra and the center, one can get that xi to the p goes to xi to the p plus f to the p of di. Same, no, if degree of f is less than p minus 1. And of course, di to the p goes to di to the p. Same from here. So for elementary mapping, to understand what happened, for linear map or for elementary map, not a problem at all. The question is, suppose we have some polynomial mapping, whose composition of elementary ones. We can rewrite it, this one, way each elementary step, and get new composition. What is the problem? Possibly, one can get same automorphism by two different ways as a composition. And possibly, logically possible, when you rewrite them in non-commutative situation to commutative situation, we will get different stuff. Logically, it is possible. You present some polynomial mapping as a composition of elementary n. This presentation may be not to be unique, have not to be unique. And for one way of presentation, one can rewrite it for commutative stuff. And for another commutative stuff. In non-commutative, result output will be the same. But maybe in commutative, output won't be the same. Same question inverse. Suppose you have symplectomorphism, which is composition of elementary mapping, and rewrite corresponding automorphism of VLI algebra. Maybe we get same result, same symplectomorphisms is presented by different ways as elementary. But if we rewrite them to the, as a polynomial, as automorphism of VLI algebras, we will get different stuff, two questions. And the only way to resolve, to prove that it's really, you will get the same, only one way to argue which we know, is reduction modulo p. Nobody knows any other proofs but reduction modulo p. Because reduction modulo p argument provides that if you rewrite elementary mapping, you will get corresponding mapping, and because restriction of endomorphism of the center is endomorphism, then it is everything is okay and it's independent on presentation. That's only one way which we know how to prove. Nobody knows any other way to other argumentation. If you found
reduction mod p is not well defined over complex numbers.
Sorry?
Reduction mod p.
Let's say for each particular automorphism, one can get big enough p and so on, so on. Ну, to be standard algebraic stuff. But it is also possible to make such p who treat for all complex numbers if you take infinitely large prime. In the sense of non-standard analysis. There is a model theory which is historically Bourbaki disliked mathematical logic because it was an enemy science. It was developed in America, in England, in Germany. Sorry for stupid argumentation. Well, my argumentation is pretty surrealistic and stupid, but it is true. And they did not accept specialist in the logical background mathematics, either as the editors of the book of Bourbaki, either as the co-authors. And they tried to ignore model theory in algebraic geometry. All through, there are many stuff in algebraic geometry can be nicely exposed via model theory. For example, you considering reduction model infinitely large primes covers all the type of problems which you ask, because you just consider reduction model infinitely large primes, and then you get everything fine. So
maybe the Jacobian conjecture or Dixmier conjecture can be also formulated over rational numbers.
Yeah. It can be formulated for rational. Then inverse, it would be automatically rational maps. You cannot get any other coefficient.
The Jacobian determinant is one.
Yeah, and let's say you can formulate it, if you have a mapping with rational coefficients, then coefficients of inverse as a formal power series would be automatically rational. So in fact, it is for algebraic numbers. It doesn't, if same for algebraic numbers, if coefficients are algebraic, then coefficients of inverse would be algebraic. Same stuff for reduction modulo P, if P is big for fixed mapping, but in order for finite set of endomorphism, one can found a prime power who serve all of them. And via some inductive limit, it's possible to consider imaginary prime number who serve all endomorphism and all coefficients. So there is a politically correct way to say this, correctly, and this provided by model theory, or so-called non-standard analysis. But for intuition, it's enough to consider P is just very big prime in order to serve each finite set of endomorphism. But unfortunately, I don't have time to discuss details. But these details, there are exposition of all of these details.
My question was whether there is a theorem which says that proving Jacobian conjecture over C yeah. is equivalent to proving it over Q.
In fact, yes. It's
Why
are
the field of zero characteristic is more or less the same?
Sorry?
I mean, the Jacobian conjecture for every field of zero characteristics is the same.
Let me say, it's not obvious. You are right. It's not.
You have more and
exactly. It's so yes. It's
complex numbers, and if you do it over Q, it doesn't imply. But if you do it over Q, then that is defined over C. And that has an inverse, and then it's okay.
Yeah, I understand your question, but I want to say it in reality, if it is true over Q, it will be true over C as well.
Not as a theorem.
If it is, let's say, first of all.
My question is whether it's a theorem in somebody's work.
Let's say, suppose if it is true for algebraic numbers,
no, Q.
Let's say, then it is true for C, for all numbers. If it is true for Q, then it is true for algebraic numbers. Maybe you need to rise up dimension. Because if it's true, say, for Q, then it is true for Q over square root of 2, say, you just can double the dimension. And via playing of this stuff, if you prove it for all dimensions over Q, this way of argumentation provides the result for all dimensions over algebraic numbers. If you prove it for all algebraic numbers, then model theory argumentation, because in order to get inverse, you need to solve some algebraic equation. And model theory argumentation will provide you that it is also true for every field of algebraic closed field of characteristic zero. Because if some statement so is true for of the first order logic. If it is true for one algebraically closed field of characteristic zero, it's true for all algebraically closed field. There is a way, such way of argumentations, but I think it is even for rationals it's possible to do more delicate argumentation. But what I said, this way of argumentation, which I said, it contains in the Van den Essen book of polynomial automorphism and Jacobian conjecture, which can be taken from the internet. Well, I think I answered your question. So it is, in fact, it is not obvious, but there are ways to get. So this is somehow motivation. And there are another conjecture, Kantsevich, is a bit surrealistic. For me it's reasonable to provide construction of infinitely large prime and non-standard analysis. Maybe somebody, not everybody familiar with ultra products and this type of construction. It is this way of construction. Suppose we have consider set of natural numbers, and every subset A, who is subset of natural numbers, we can measure, put the measure either mu of A is either zero or either one. Every subset we can evaluate with measure one over measure zero, such that complement of set of measure one is measure zero and vice versa. And union of any two sets of measure zero is set of measure zero as well. Also, it's possible can suppose that every finite set has a measure zero. This is ultrafilter. If you have numbers, if you have number, non-standard number is a sequence xi. I belongs, say, to n. And x is equal y equal x if xi equal yi almost everywhere for set of indices of measure one.
For fixed measure.
For fixed ultra filter. What does it mean x is a natural number? It means that xi belongs to n almost everywhere. What does it mean x is prime? It means xi is a prime number almost everywhere. What does it mean infinite construction of infinitely small number? One, two, one, three, and so on. Because standard number can be embedded as a constant. And it becomes bigger than same way to infinitely large. One, two, and so on. It's easy to infinitely large numbers. Reduction modulo P, it means that on position you get almost everywhere reduction. Of course, the set of numbers is a field. It provides many properties, and this is way to define correctly infinitely large primes and whatever. And another conjecture was stated a bit surrealistic way. Prove that this endomorphism, automorphism, is independent on the choice of infinitely large prime. Formulation looks a bit surrealistic, but it is also difficult conjecture, which I have put in some in other paper on archive.
So, this is now I want to so this I gave motivation of this to conjecture. I gave provide a proof which was well known for tame automorphisms. Now I want to say how general proof is going in because I think how many time I have?
Like 10 minutes.
Okay. Let me at least I can point out the structure of proof of Kontsevich conjecture. First of all, it's pretty natural to approach, it's not idea at all, it is pretty natural approach to use approximation of polynomial endomorphism by tame ones. Indeed, there is, what does it mean? what does it mean? First of all, if you consider polynomial automorphism saying xi goes to xi plus fi di goes to di plus gi and coefficients of fi and gi are small, no, in some sense, no algebraic sense, no belongs to some ideal. No, in the ring of coefficients, no ideal of elements of small, then really this polynomial map and all coefficients, suppose coefficients of fi belong to some ideal A, then modulo A power n for any n, one can approximate it by tame automorphisms. No, that's result of this. It was a result for Anik for ordinary automorphism and for simple ectomorphism and same for automorphism of Wiele algebra. It was also it's not very difficult result, but no, still not so trivial. At least it was published in Communications in Algebra. It's not high positional journal. No, it is good journal, but not high ranking journal. So to prove it, it's not, it's somehow natural way to prove, and you don't need to make some mathematical invention in order to prove all of these properties of approximations of this. The question is following. If you define Lie algebra in natural way for automorphisms of Wiele algebra, and if you define in natural way Lie algebra structure of polynomial simple ectomorphism, then became not isomorphical. No, because it's somehow infinitely dimensional algebraic groups, which is for finitely dimensional algebraic groups, they are varieties without singularity. Because however, infinitely dimensional algebraic groups has very suspicious and not very nice properties. So direct approximation does not work so well. It in for example, if you consider in order to treat Wiele algebra, one can, in order to do approximation, one can consider algebra with this commutator relations. Dj would be delta ij times h, where h is new variable which called to be Planck constant. No, new generators who belongs to the center of algebras. And if one consider introduce these new generators, and then first of all approximation start working, and some important properties of this approximation can be established.
It's and then it's possible to come back to the case when H is 1. But first, it is important to introduce. And if you introduce, then indeed, if you have polynomial endomorphism, and if you do approximation and consider corresponding lifting to differential operators with H, result of lifting indeed would be independent on the way how you approximate. It's not obvious, but because if you approximate on the side of simple ectomorphism, and if you lift it to non-commutative case, why approximation, different ways of approximation provide the same result? That's really non-trivial, but it is true, and it is and it's possible to prove it. No, this is one chapter in my paper, which I put in archive. It's one important part of it, that it is really, because naive way, if you don't introduce H, you might have dependence, but here you don't have all way of approximations provide the same result. This result can be output, however, can be not polynomial mapping, but power series, possibly infinite. But it is canonical. And the second chapter proves that it is really polynomial maps. It's not obvious, it's used canonically, and I can prove it only for automorphism. I cannot prove it for endomorphisms. So question about endomorphism is still open. So that it would be. And then the third part is dedicated to prove that in reality, one can, from this, one can get to the case when H is 1. It is not so difficult, but it is some job in order to do it. And then one can get its Kantsevich conjecture. This is one plan of the proof. I cannot go to the details, I just outlined the proof, but it is in archive. Now I want to say one important thing, and community, for example, there is a paper of Dot. No, we wrote paper after Dot. We wrote paper independently of Dot. Dot put it 2 years ago. But Kantsevich still did not succeed to understand Christopher Dot paper. So if this paper is correct, then Dot did before me. But it contains, in any case, it contains many important ideas, Christopher Dot, and community would be grateful if somebody prove it. Oh, sorry. One second. Ален? Нет, не звонил. Ага, всего доброго, я на лекции. Ну, сори. So if somebody, there is a paper of Christopher Dot, and it is it provides solution of this, it's correct, it contains many ideas, but it is very technical paper, very difficult. Of course, I wish it would be correct, because different way and we are not making any competition. But it still looks, so if somebody understand paper of Christopher Dot, so many people would be grateful to such person, including Kashdan, Kantsevich. So if somebody succeed in understand of Christopher Dot paper.
I just want to say that I read, I did not succeed, but I will still try to do it. No, about his paper. So I put in archive, in my archive paper, there is a reference of Christopher Dodd paper. And because if it is correct, then it provides some very nice and important ideas. No, respect to this, and it is very important to understand for community. And maybe output it is that Jacobian conjecture. What vocal, of course, some people work on Jacobian conjecture just to solve it, to get everything or nothing. Of course, usually person get nothing. But this conjecture now can be put in the neighborhood of some statement which can make some its own sense and can be interesting by itself. I think that the Kontsevich conjecture is interesting result. And maybe I gave some argumentation why this result is interesting, this theorem. And such theorems, maybe is, even if of course, if not result of Jacobian conjecture, I don't think my work about this area was quite unsuccessful. At least some result, some nice theorem, or theorem which I consider to be nice, provided. Even so, if other generation will succeed, okay. But so far, I think something, some ideas and some relation with quantization is provided. And the area of polynomial endomorphisms, it is a new way of looking on the mainstream quantization, because no, usually people look, no, as all community looks on the quantization, but this provides new vision of the quantization. For example, not everybody needs to work on mainstream just as mainstream. I think we need to have scientific variety. No, in some sense, not everybody works. For example, there is a Biancar problem. Suppose you embed line in three-dimensional space, algebraic embedding, OVC. Is it true that all embedding are equivalent? It means that can you have a complex knot in the algebraic sense? Nobody knows about it. For real, one can note it by real mapping. So even for mainstream, different areas provide different light, and it might produce something. And so thank you for inviting me again.
Well, thank you.
Not about your work, but about this approach to algebraic geometry through model theory. So, is there some treatment of algebraic geometry from the point of view of model theory or not?
So I recommend to read papers of Khrushchevsky. Khrushchevsky, once Kashdan was very skeptical on the model theory, but he was convinced by Khrushchevsky in Hebrew University. And he changed opinion. Now he does not contain it as a nonsense, it's as a serious stuff. So there are some papers of Khrushchevsky or Boris Zilbert about relations of algebraic geometry and no model theory. So nowadays people are working in this area. So this stuff is with Bourbaki is not forever.
Can you repeat again how you have got a lift from you have started in characteristic E and finally you have applied the Jacobian conjecture of integral equation. How this lift was
Because easiest way to put P is infinitely large number. When you do it the P,
you can forget the structure of infinitely large numbers. Then field of a characteristic P became field of characteristic zero.
Yeah,
there is way without infinitely large numbers. So Jacobian, if Jacobian, if you have, if characteristic of P is big enough, respect to degree, fixed degree and number of variables, then inverse in the characteristic P is equivalent to invertibility over the C. There is a way to do it. So let's say that if Jacobian conjecture over C is true, then for any fixed amount of variable and for any fixed degree, it is true for all field of characteristic P for mappings with fixed number of variables and fixed degree. So it's possible without infinitely large, but just replace kind of using this stuff.
Okay. There was one question about the conjectures. All of them are about the affine space. I mean,
yeah, yeah.
And what are examples?
Let's say if you try to get to formulate Dixmier conjecture for non-affine space, you very quickly get not very interesting counterexample. And all of this subject is about the difference between affine space and other spaces. Affine space has a huge automorphism group respect to all others. So if you generalize it to some, you usually get non-interesting examples, counterexamples.
Are there any more questions? So if not, let's thank you for joining.